The Chenery Middle School introduced a composting pilot last December. The school teamed up with Black Earth Compost, a local company which collects food scraps to help turn those scraps into nutrient-rich soil. Student volunteers, also called trash bashers, have been hard at work to make the new program work. Outgoing principal Mike McAllister spoke with Belmont Journal volunteer Komako Akai Whitelaw about the program.
In December of this year, we started asking students to do something different in the cafeteria, and it was to separate their organic food waste from the rest of their trash, putting one in a composting bin and one in a trash can. The reason we did that is because we were seeing that our trash was increasing and increasing and increasing. And what we have to be able to do, all of us, is decrease and decrease and decrease. So last spring at Chenery, we started to have conversations about whether composting was a viable option for us. At the end of the day, we're asking people to do more work. We're asking custodians to do more work. We're asking maintenance to do more work. We're asking students to do more work. And what we decided is we were going to move really slowly in order to get it right. We were aware of Black Earth Composting as a company that's located just a little bit north of here. They were doing curbside composting for the Belmont community as well as a few communities around here. So what they said is if they get new customers, they were able to take some of that money and set it aside for a fund where we could actually bring that into some kind of municipal building. There was a lot of question as, you know, are middle school students going to be able to do this? And can, you know, what will it take? And are we going to be able to teach them? And what I've learned is that not a lot of kids are coming from homes that are composting, although the good news is I think that's getting higher. But most of them have taken to it pretty easily. You watch kids come up really carefully and separate. They pour out their liquids and they put their containers in and then they tip their tray and then they stack their tray. We've been helped by the trash bashers who help arrange that, but I've been impressed. One of the big changes I've seen is just how kids have adjusted to that. So we used to put out anywhere between 12 and 19 bags of trash for an average day of lunch. And now we're putting out about 3 to 6 bags of trash. So that's a huge decrease. So they pick up from us three per day, three large bins of composting food. It's all food scraps. They then bring it to their site and they go through a process of actually breaking it down, mixing it with other dirts, making sure it organically decays appropriately. And at the end, what's the final product? The final product is this amazingly nutrient-rich dirt that they actually then, part of their business model is they then sell that to consumers.
It's better than having it all go to, like, the trash, because there's, like, it makes methane, and that's not good. So if you turn it into soil, it can help grow plants, which helps with global warming.
My message for your Chenery student is that even if your friends are telling you you're disgusting doing that, you're not. You're doing something important and great for the earth, and you can continue doing it, and you don't have to be scared of putting your hand in the trash.
So now our hope is that now that they're learning here and they realize that it can be a pretty easy process, when they go to be adults themselves, it'll be a normal process that they've been doing all.